Cigarette smoking is one of the most important global health problems. The World Health Organization estimates that tobacco kills about 6 million people each year. Cigarette smoking has a causal effect on many cancers, heart disease, stroke, respiratory diseases, you name it. But everybody knows this, right? And yet, for decades, cigarette ads showed tough, healthy men smoking. But reality is something hard to argue against. At least 4 Marlboro men died of smoking-related diseases. And some well-known Hollywood actors also advertised cigarettes. One died of cancer, the other of dementia. Which begs the question, does smoking have a causal effect on the risk of dementia? There are biological reasons why smoking may increase the risk of at least some forms of dementia. However, we will never have a randomized trial of cigarette smoking. Fortunately, such an ethical trial is not allowed. That means that we'll have to rely on observational data only. In fact, several observational prospective studies of smoking and dementia have been conducted since the 1990s. However, the findings of these observational studies vary dramatically. Some studies found a higher risk of dementia in smokers than in non-smokers. Other studies found the opposite. Can we interpret any of these associations as the effect of smoking on dementia? And if so, what's the answer? Does smoking cause or prevent dementia? And most importantly, why do results differ across studies? One possibility is uncontrolled confounding in some of the studies. For example, by alcohol. People who become cigarette smokers also tend to drink more alcohol. If alcohol increases the risk of dementia, then we would expect to find an association between smoking and dementia, even if smoking had no effect on dementia. But it looks like many observational studies of smoking and dementia did adjust for the most important confounders. Then why did the smokers have a higher risk of dementia in some studies and a lower risk of dementia in other studies? Let me give you a hint. Perhaps it has to do with the selection of individuals in each of these studies. We will return to this problem at the end of this lesson, and by then you will be able to explain what's going on here.